After Diddy and his legal team unsuccessfully argued that he should be released on bond during his arraignment on Tuesday, the rapper is currently being held at the notorious Metropolitan Detention Center in Brooklyn. Welcome back, it's your host Nancy Brown. If you are new here, make sure you have subscribed to our YouTube channel. According to Rolling Stone, the prosecution's argument against allowing him back on the streets included worries that he could try to get in touch with potential victims and witnesses. The bad boy mogul was mentioned for reportedly blowing up his dirty money bandmate Kalenna Harper's phone after Don Richard, the other member of the group, accused him in a lawsuit of sexual abuse, sex trafficking, fraud, and other offenses. The state asserts that in only 4 days, he spoke with Harper 128 times via phone and text. Assistant U.S. Attorney Emily Johnson argued in the courtroom, "Witnesses have universally expressed fear of the defendant." Diddy's attorney, Marc Agnifilo, had offered to pay $50 million for bail, and said that his client would remain on house arrest in Miami with constant surveillance. Judge Robyn Tarnofsky wasn't impressed by the offer. "This is a crime that happens behind closed doors, even when pretrial services is monitoring," she ruled, as caught by CNN. 50 Cent has consistently made fun of Diddy whenever he gets the chance. All in all, it's one of his favorite things to do. Because of the numerous accusations made against the music mogul, he has had a lot of opportunity to do it recently. As a matter of fact, Diddy was formally charged with kidnapping, racketeering, and even sex trafficking earlier today. According to the indictment, Diddy ran a vast criminal enterprise that aimed to both traffic women for sex and carry out purported drug operations. There are several passages in the indictment discussing the purported evidence that was seized during the historic searches in March. Right now, one piece of evidence is causing everyone on the planet to talk. Naturally, we are referring to the purported 1,000 baby oil lubricant bottles that were seized. According to the state, this lubricant was kept on hand at several hotels where Diddy and his friends were known to have freak-offs. Now, 50 Cent is taking aim at Diddy in the best manner he knows how. "Here I am keeping good company with at Drew Barrymore TV and I don't have 1,000 bottles of lube at the house," Fiff wrote. How does 50 use Drew Barrymore to poke fun at Diddy must be on everyone's mind. Still, supporters had been waiting for Fiff to make a statement like this. It was only a matter of time until it happened. Fans will therefore just need to wait and see how this Diddy lawsuit plays out. He is still incarcerated as of right now. Aubrey O'Day claims she feels validated following Diddy's arrest by police on Monday night on allegations of sex trafficking and possible racketeering conspiracy. Soon after the news broke, she posted the remarks on X, according to Diddy's attorney Marc Agnifilo, who spoke to media outside the courtroom. "Diddy plans to enter a not guilty plea. He's not guilty. He's innocent of these charges." Shortly after the arrest, O'Day wrote, "The purpose of justice is to provide an ending and allow us the space to create a new chapter. Women never get this. I feel validated. Today is a win for women all over the world, not just me. Things are finally changing." When reporter Yasher Ali noted that fans have bullied, terrorized, and threatened O'Day over the years for vocalizing her claims about Diddy, she responded, "He did worse than that to me. And thank you, Yasher, for this post. Appreciate you being in my corner and believing me." So, as a legend in the hip-hop industry, Foxy Brown has undoubtedly witnessed a lot of bad things happen over her career. Diddy, the rap mogul, has been at the center of one of the hip-hop industry's biggest storylines this year. Foxy Brown and Diddy collaborated, and she undoubtedly had personal interactions with him. In fact, she faced criticism when, in the wake of the mogul's numerous accusations, she stood by him last year. But for now, all she's doing is responding to the most recent event in the narrative. She posted two wide-eyed, surprised face emojis to her Instagram story. Despite the fact that she didn't really say anything, it is clear what she is referring about. This morning on The Breakfast Club, Charlamagne issued a fair warning to everyone who might have been connected to Diddy.
"He gets racketeering and sex trafficking for freak-offs. It will be others involved."
In the end, he decided to focus on the supposedly Diddy parties that have gained mythology in recent months. The entire Breakfast Club panel was naturally interested in the arrests and what they might signal for the business as a whole.
"Like, if you ever ran a train with Diddy, you're probably going to jail." Yeah.
There's no doubting that this might be a historic indictment, and the hip-hop community as a whole is paying notice.
"Have you ever been butt-naked anywhere with Diddy, and there was some women around, awesome men around, that he told you were part of the party? You're probably going to jail."
El Charlamagne said. "It is an interesting prediction, but it is assuming a lot right now. Only time will tell what comes of all of this." On Monday night in New York, Diddy was recently detained and placed under federal prison. Diddy was detained late on Monday night after Homeland Security stormed into a Midtown hotel where he was staying. Unverified rumors have it that the feds are looking into his hotel room. Diddy was reportedly brought to the FBI field office located in Manhattan. The action seems to have been related to the ongoing criminal investigation into allegations of sex trafficking and other charges, which resulted in the issuance and execution of search warrants at Diddy's residences in Miami. and Beverly Hills. As we previously reported, over the past few months, a grand jury has been hearing testimony from a variety of accusers. Diddy's attorney, Marc Agnifilo, says, "We are disappointed with the decision to pursue what we believe is an unjust prosecution of Mr. Combs by the U.S. Attorney's Office." Sean Diddy Combs is a music icon, self-made entrepreneur, loving family man, and proven philanthropist who has spent the last 30 years building an empire, adoring his children, and working to uplift the black community. Agnifilo adds, "He is an imperfect person but is not criminal." To his credit, Mr. Combs has been nothing but cooperative with this investigation, and he voluntarily relocated to New York last week in anticipation of these charges. "Please reserve your judgment until you have all the facts. These are the acts of an innocent man with nothing to hide, and he looks forward to clearing his name in court." Diddy was wandering around New York City with his kid King Combs with confidence, just a few hours before he was nabbed. He even stopped to greet some admirers and snap selfies. Tuesday was the planned day for Diddy's arrest. However, something occurred that prompted the federal agents to move in one day early. U.S. Attorney Damian Williams, however, claims that he was arrested by federal investigators in response to a sealed indictment that the Southern District of New York had filed.